Good afternoon. Thanks for joining us across the fence. I'm Fran Stoddard. Today we're traveling halfway around the world. Our destination is the country of Nepal. The reason for this particular journey centers on farming and the work of a scientist with the University of Vermont Extension and the Plant and Soil Science Department. It's a pleasure to welcome Ann Hazelrig.
Thanks.
We've talked before. Ann, of course, is a plant pathologist and the director of UVM's Plant Diagnostic Clinic. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
So cool that you went to Nepal.
Yeah.
So tell us first about this. How did it come about?
Well, this is probably my sixth time to Nepal, and I go over with a project. It's called Farmer to Farmer, and it's a USAID project. Yeah, and what it does is it takes volunteers from the United States to countries that need help, their farmers need help, and it could be a disease issue or maybe animal nutrition or something like that. But I go over with this Farmer to Farmer group, and there are several different granting agencies that get this Farmer to Farmer project, and they're all in different countries.
Huh.
So I really like going to Nepal. I've been to India, Nepal, Honduras. So I've gone with Winrock before, and I've also gone, this last time, the group that's doing Nepal is Catholic Relief Services. Huh. So I went over with them. And what you do is you just go on their website, all these different websites, and there's a little bar where you can click on volunteer on all those
this
different
agencies. This is USAID.
Agencies. Yeah, it's the farmer.
Not just for academics, but
no, yeah. It's for anybody. It's anybody that's got some expertise. A lot of our Vermont farmers have gone over to help other farmers, so it's a great opportunity. So you click on the volunteer button on each page of these agencies, and they'll list all the scopes of work in the different countries. And so if there's something that you match with, and I matched with this one, they were looking for a plant pathologist to go over and work on this disease called clubroot. So if you're interested in the assignment, you talk with the recruiter, and you send a CV, and they take a look and see if you really do fit. And then if you do, then they send you a more detailed scope of work of what the assignment is. So my scope of work was, there were three different objectives with this clubroot disease, and it was to improve farmers' knowledge on the disease and how to manage it, and then do some on-farm training so they get better at diagnosis of diseases.
Right.
They also need a lot of help with pesticide safety and fungicide use and things like that. And then the third objective, which I need to do soon, is they want to have some document where they can work with farmers who didn't show up to the training. And so I think we're going to do a calendar of all these brassica diseases and management. So all the farmers, they're going to translate it into
Nepalese.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
And UVM supports you in doing
this. Yeah, they've always considered it to be part of my extension work, which I've been really grateful for.
Fantastic. So many of us, of course, have heard of Nepal as the place where Mount Everest is.
Right.
But what else? What is the landscape like where you were working? Where were you working?
Yeah, I was working. I flew into Kathmandu. It's a landlocked country in between India and China, two of the most populated countries in the world. You fly into Kathmandu, and then where I worked was a region called the Makwanpur area. It was about 48 miles southwest of Kathmandu, which took us 4 to 5 hours to get there. So the roads are not very good, but it was a beautiful area. 90% of the people in the area are engaged in farming. So it's off-season vegetables, but they're these really small, diversified farms where they grow rice, vegetables, kind of a little bit of everything. But the brassica crops, cauliflower, cabbage, were one of their mainstays that they grew.
And they were having trouble with that. What do you mean by off-season?
Well, I think
it gets too cold, or
Yeah, I think the main season is considered rice. And so then anything outside of the rice season is considered off season.
Got it. Got it. So your expertise was sought to work on this club root. So what is club root?
Well, it's a pretty fascinating soil-borne disease. And it, what it does is during rainy parts, if you have a rainy season, you can lose your whole cabbage or cauliflower crop to this disease. And what you see on the symptoms, it, you know, it just wilts and dies. But if you dig up the plant, there are these huge clubby galls on the root. So that impedes all the water and nutrients getting up to the top of the plant, and it dies.
And is this something we have here at all? Or
yeah,
we do.
But the difference is that our farmers have such a much larger land base that one of the management options for this disease is to rotate for 7 years out of that field.
Out of that field.
Whereas the Nepali people, they don't have that luxury. There's not, they just can't do it. So they need other management options. But there's no easy fix to that disease, unfortunately.
So we'll get back to that, but how were you able to communicate your knowledge to the Nepalese people? I mean, do you speak Nepalese?
No, I wish. I wish. You know, it's really great. The Catholic Relief Services or whomever you're going with always provides an interpreter. And I've just had the best luck and time with these. They're really well handpicked, and he really took care of me, and so he interpreted all my lectures and things like that. And we also, so the man in the foreground was my interpreter, Chan. We were all having tea after one of the lectures. And the young man in the glasses over on the right, they always try to involve university students in the area. So this was a young Ag University student, and he came along and he served as my interpreter for a lot of it because he understood a lot of the concepts. And I think one of my biggest impacts was working with him, because by the time we were done, he could give lectures.
Exactly, which is perfect.
Yeah, and he loved it. He was thrilled.
Well, you know, what can these farmers do about the club root if they can't move, or can they rotate a little bit, at least have a different crop?
Well, they can, and I've got, I can talk more about management, but one thing we did do when we were there, we went out in the field with all the farmers, and that was part of it, to look at the symptoms in the field, and they were unclear. Some of the diseases that we looked at were bacterial, and they were spraying fungicides for that. So it was very good to, you know, try to clear that sort of thing up.
Right.
But as far as management, there's, you know, they would love to have a pesticide option, which is the easiest thing, but there is no pesticide. And that's one thing that I drove home, is that if somebody's trying to sell you pesticides for this, it's not going to work.
Right.
And the way to, the place to concentrate your efforts are in cultural practices and things like that. Lower on the IPM triangle is what we call it. So as you go up in this IPM triangle, it gets more intervention. So there are lots of things they can do. One thing is the disease does not, there's a part of the disease that isn't active above a certain pH, above 7.2, and their pHs were around 4.0 to 5.0. So if they could raise their pH, that's a big help. Rotating between crop families, they didn't understand rotation. They were putting cabbage and then cauliflower, which is
same family.
Right. So that was something we talked about. And the longer the rotation, the better it is. They can't do 7 years, but maybe they could do 3 seasons.
Right.
The other thing is sanitation. The disease overwinters in the soil in those big clubby galls. So if they clean up the crop at the end of the season, that's another option. They're resistant cultivars. I came over, I took some resistant seed over, and that's another really good option for them. And the farmers were really pretty reluctant because they said, oh, it's way too expensive. We can't do that. But one of the things I try to impress upon them is, well, keep track, you know, keep records.
And in the long term.
Yeah, well, and see how much you've spent for seed, track your yield, and maybe you'll find out that this seed is actually, you know, worth purchasing.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, that's great tips for them, and hopefully, and it's great that you go back to see how these different think problems that you've helped, you know, are doing.
Most likely. The other thing they need to do is to keep looking for other high value crops and just try to expand their, you know, what they grow.
Right. So you've made multiple trips, I guess six to Nepal, and you're generally in the same area of the country. I mean.
No, I go, I've
been different places depending on what's needed.
Right. Every time I've gone, it's been to a different area. So I've been in far eastern Nepal, and I've been down on the Terai, which is the, like, right next to the Indian border, the plains. And I've been to the Midwest. But I really like the assignments that are up in the hills rather than down on the Indian border.
So this was at like 7,000 feet or something. It was actually pretty high, and it's terraced.
All the fields are terraced just because of, you know, everything's on a hillside. And so you can, on certain, it was not the best time of year to see Everest and some of the tall mountains, but we did get a few glimpses of them.
They're there.
Yeah, they're there. Okay. Behind the monsoon clouds.
And so what keeps you going back? I mean, if there, I see that they also grow potatoes and chili and bell peppers and things like that.
Yeah.
So there are other things that they could put into rotation.
Right, there are.
And do you go back and see
Well,
what's
one of
happened,
my assignments or? Is, and one thing I suggested to this group is, you know, tomatoes are a really high value crop. And I've gone over before to work with women, teaching them how to graft resistant rootstocks onto tomatoes. So I sort of put the bug in their ear that I should come back and do this.
Okay. Awesome. I'm sure they can't wait. Ann Haselrig, thank you so much. Such interesting work. Thank you for sharing
You're
your
welcome.
Stories of Nepal with us.
Yeah, thank you.
And thank you for joining us Across the Fence. I'm Fran Stoddard.